Let us discuss about seismic displacement, sensing accelerometer, or we can call it as potentiometric accelerometer. This accelerometer we are using for finding the acceleration of the vehicle, or we can tell vibrations of the vehicle or vibrations of the given machine, lathe machine, drilling machine or milling machine, or vibrations of the motor. So we can find vibrations of a given motor or engine. So here we are calling two names, seismic displacement sensing accelerometer, or we are using the potentiometer for finding the vibrations. That's why we can call it as potentiometric accelerometer. Here there are two types in it. First one is linear seismic displacement sensing accelerometer, okay, and the second one is rotational seismic displacement sensing accelerometer. In today's class we will discuss the first type. It is linear seismic displacement sensing accelerometer. Let us take the diagram here first. So you need to take the basic principle, how it is working, on which basic principle it is working. So this is the accelerometer. This is very small in size compared to the motor or engine or any machine. Let us take, this is a motor. We are keeping this small instrument on it for finding the vibrations of this motor. If motor is vibrating, so this instrument is also vibrating. This accelerometer will also vibrate. So here by using the potentiometer we can find the vibrations. Let us see here what is the basic principle. Here we have one arrangement, mass is connected to spring and damper. One side it has spring, one side it has damper, okay. Whenever vibrations are coming of the given engine or motor, the entire accelerometer will vibrate, okay. Because of it, this mass will also vibrating, okay. It has spring also, so this spring is vibrating and mass will also vibrate. The displacement will measure the vibrations of a given motor or engine, okay. It is the main basic principle. So here what is the main, how can we write the basic principle means, when a spring, mass and damper system is subjected to acceleration, that is vibrations, the mass is displaced, and this displacement of the mass is proportional to the acceleration of the motor or engine, okay. Hence measure of this displacement, if you measure this displacement, it is a measurement of the vibrations of a given motor or engine, okay. It is a main basic principle. Let us take the description of this accelerometer. In it, as I told previously, first part is mass. Here we can call it as sensing mass. This mass is connected to the one frame here. We can call it as housing frame. So this mass is connected to the housing frame through spring. Okay, so this is the first part. And the next part is this mass is connected to the damper. Okay, and it is connected to the housing. So this is the first part, spring and mass to the housing. And next part is this damper is connected to mass and housing. This is the second part. So in the damper we are taking the oil. It is a viscous oil. Okay, why we are connecting the mass to the damper means it will give the support to the mass. If it is missing here, this mass will have no support. It is unnecessarily vibrating. Okay, because with the it is connected to the spring. So for avoiding those vibrations, we are connecting this mass to the damper. It is giving the cushioning effect as well as support to the mass. This is the second part. And third one is, whatever sensing mass is there, it is connected to the here one transducer, electric transducer we can call it as, okay, or we can call it as potentiometer also, okay. Whatever mass is vibrating, the how much displacement of the mass, this transducer we can find, okay, by using the electrical energy. So we can call it as potentiometer also. That's why the another name of this is potentiometric accelerometer. These three are the main parts in the description. Let us take the working operation of this accelerometer. Here, as I told previously, if you want to find the vibrations of a given machine or motor, we have to keep this accelerometer above it. Okay, so let us take, we are keeping on any machine. Okay, here machine is there. If machine is running, this accelerometer will have vibrations like this. It is moving up and down. Okay, the entire frame is vibrating. Because of it, spring has also vibrations. This mass will displace. Okay, so whatever displacement is there, we can see in the electrical transducer. Okay, if vibrations are more, the displacement of mass will be also more. Okay, it is a main basic operation of this accelerometer. This displacement of this mass we can find by using the electrical transducer. We can call it as potentiometer also. Okay, so here how the potentiometer we can connect, I will explain. Here we can use the Wheatstone bridge for finding the displacement. Here we have to find the displacement. Here let us take the arrangement will be, let us assume this is a pointer. Okay, with the vibrations here instead of electrical transducer, what I did means, what the electrical transducer will do means, here whatever displacement is there, so here I am connecting one pointer, here I am taking one resistance, this pointer is displacing on the resistance, this resistance is changing with displacement. Okay, so this resistance we can measure at the output. How can we measure the resistance at output means, we have to connect this resistance to Wheatstone bridge by using, this is the balanced bridge, we can find the change in resistance in that balanced bridge. Let us see how this Wheatstone bridge is working first. So in that Wheatstone bridge we can find the this resistance, how the resistance is changing. Okay, this resistance, change in resistance will measure the machine vibrations. Okay, let us see the Wheatstone bridge. Let us take the Wheatstone bridge, how it is working. First it has four resistance, R1 R2 R3 R4. This bridge, this resistance are symmetrical about horizontal axis and vertical axis. Now for supplying the current to this bridge, we are taking the battery here. The amount of current we can control by using the rheostat. By changing the resistance, whatever current we want, we can supply to the bridge. Here, let us take at this after arrangement. Okay, so we know this R1 value, resistance R1, R2 value we know, R3 value we know, R4 we don't know. Let us assume like that. We have to find R4. Okay, we are supplying some current, so that in it some, it is showing some current, G value. G means galvanometer, it is showing some current, means this amount of current is passing in this circuit. Here what you do means, adjust this current so that whatever current inside this galvanometer is zero. Keep this is zero by changing this rheostat. Okay, at that time I is zero is called null position. Okay, at that I zero, we can call this bridge is in balanced condition. Balanced condition means the ratio of resistance this side is equal to ratio of this resistance this side. Means R1 by R4 is equal to R2 by R3. Ratio of these two resistance is equal to ratio of these two resistance. When it is possible means, when the galvanometer reading I is zero. Okay, by using this formula, we can find R4. R4 is equal to, this side R4 will go, R1 is as it is, into R3 by R2. So this is the main use of this Wheatstone bridge of finding the resistance. Okay, so just now I told we have to connect this resistance to the Wheatstone bridge. The entire arrangement we can call it as potentiometer. That's why we can call it as potentiometric accelerometer. Potentiometer is finding the change in resistance. Okay, this change in resistance will find the vibrations of a given machine. So it is main working operation of this accelerometer. Here what are the applications of this accelerometer means, we can use for the automobile vehicles or machines or engines, IC engines, motors, okay, machines like that. And what are the advantages means, it is very simple arrangement, cost is also less, and easy to find the displacement or vibrations of a machine. It is very sensitive, giving the correct value of the vibrations of a given machine. What are the limitations of it means, here this spring will lose its property with time. We have to replace this spring, okay, periodically for getting the proper displacement. So these are the main points of the linear seismic displacement sensing accelerometer. We can call this as the potentiometric accelerometer.